This screencast gives an example of two types of homogeneous equations. The first type is a general homogeneous equation, and that means that it is valid for any system of units. In other words, SI, English units, any of them, it will be valid for. The other is what's known as a restricted homogeneous equation, and it is valid only for one set of units. The fact that it's restricted doesn't mean that it's not homogeneous. What it means is that it can only be used for that one set of units that it's been derived for. So let's take a look at an equation, and this is the equation for the volumetric flow rate over a dam. And this B is the length of the dam, and the H is the height of the water. And the first thing we want to know is that 3.09, is that dimensionless or does it have units? So our Q, volumetric flow rate, is L cubed over T equals 3.09. B is length. H is length now raised to the 3/2. So this is the same as 3.09 L to the 5/2. Well, on the left-hand side, we have L cubed over T. We have L to the 5/2. So in order for this to be homogeneous, same dimensions on both sides, this 3.09 has to have the units of L to the 1/2 over T, and now times L to the 5/2. So is this a general or a restricted homogeneous equation? And the answer is that this is restricted. Because you have a constant that has units, as soon as you change your system, you're going to end up having to change that constant, and therefore the exact equation will not be valid. So let's take a look at another example. One of the parameters that we use in fluids is known as the Froude number, and it's defined as the velocity divided by the square root of g times L, where g is gravity and L is a length. So let's see what the units of the Froude number are. So this is L over T divided by L over T squared, which is gravity, times L. So this is dimensionless. And since there is no constant, it can be used for any system of units. And let me give you an example. Let's say we have a velocity of 5 feet per second. Gravity is 32.2 feet per second squared, and our length is 3 feet. So when we calculate the Froude number, it's 5 feet per second divided by the square root of 32.2 feet per second squared times 3 feet. And we calculate that and we come up with a Froude number of 0.509. Now let's say we want to put it instead in the metric system. So our velocity is going to be 5 feet per second, and our conversion factor, 0.3048 meters per feet, gives us a velocity of 1.524 meters per second. Gravity in the SI units is 9.8 meters per second squared, and our length is going to be 3 feet. And again, our conversion factor from meters to feet, and our length is going to end up being 0.9144 meters. So now let's put that in the Froude number. So the Froude number equals our velocity, which is 1.524 meters per second, divided by the square root of 9.8 meters per second squared times 0.9144 meters. And when you do the calculations, you come out with a Froude number of 0.509. So this Froude equation is general. It can be used for any system of units.